So for the last couple of months, I've been thinking about doing the Nintendo Directs that have been coming out. But I thought to myself, you know, I don't think there's going to be any big announcements. I feel like it's perfectly fine to skip this one. I mean, really, what are they actually going to announce on... Well, you know what? At least I know for sure they won't do it a second time.
God dang it! So that's why we're here today, folks. Because two times in a row, I have failed to watch the Nintendo Direct thinking there would be nothing at all worth watching. And both times, a big reveal for Smash Brothers appeared on those directs. I love Super Smash Brothers a lot. You know all those reaction YouTubers that scream like little baby? That's me. I'm the baby. So seeing I blew those opportunities, I actually came up with a cool idea of just watching every single one of the character reveal trailers and rating them to see which ones are the best and which ones are the worst. Because ever since, I think, Snake in Brawl, they have been fantastic at just raising the hype for Smash Brothers and really just video game history in general. So today we're going to look through all of them. I gotta go fix SpongeBob. He's drunk, and I'm worried I'm gonna step on a thumbtack later. Of course, folks, like, check out the original link, more for original content creator. Link me in the description. Also, I should mention, I just found a compilation of all the reveals. I did take out some of them because some of them were just the intros to Melee and Brawl, and I don't know. I didn't find them that. I mean, they're really nothing to add other than this. Which is fair enough. I mean, that one already, 5 stars, 5-star reveal, 5-star reveal. If I could give them 6, I would, but we're doing a 5-star system here. So we're going to start off with the ending of the Smash trailer, I think it was. And I find to be probably the start of what is the Smash trailers today. This was the moment that made everybody go insane because it was something that no one expected. And it seemed like a pipe dream, which seems to be the new theme of Smash Brothers. What you thought was a pipe dream is happening, and you don't know how. And you're just like, did I die and go to heaven?
Snake.
Oh. I knew this was in Japanese. Was it originally in Japanese? I don't remember.
Oh.
That gives all the boys the boners? Yes, I know. Look how good this is! Oh, I don't remember. I don't think it was in the background the whole time. That's what I would have done. I would have had the box. Oh god, I still got chills.
Showtime.
Oh! It's been freaking years since I've watched that, but I still got the chills that I did when I first saw it. To see a character that was very much known as a Sony property coming on over and being in Smash Brothers was in freaking insane. And it's this weird thing where you hear characters talk about other franchises, like having Snake say, oh, you mean that Nintendo game? What is going on? Why is that finely voiced Asian man saying things in my ear that are just getting me all a tither? I don't know, but I stinking love it. And I think at this moment, when Snake was put into Smash Brothers, it really cemented Smash as a game that isn't just a highlight of Nintendo characters. Because that's what it was really when I think Melee came out. It was a love letter to all Nintendo franchises. But at this moment, it became a love letter to video games. When you see how much passion is put into every character, and not just that, their stages or the music, especially the music, because the remixes are gorgeous. You can tell Sakurai and his team puts a lot of research into these franchises. Now, as far as rating goes, Snake's a hard one because nostalgia makes me say this is a 5 out of 5. But I'm worried that once I give this a 5, I'm going to change all my scorings once I get to the top, and I give too many 5s. But I have to say, I think this is a 5-star character reveal. Nobody saw it coming. It was fantastic. Everything about it, the fact that it goes black and you get the famous, like, talk screens that they do in Metal Gear, and you're instantly, you're engaged, you're like, what's happening? And the more they talk, the more you're going nuts. And then the reveal of him under the box saying, newcomer, it's great stuff. It's great stuff. I debated about making it a 4 or a 4.5, but seeing this as the beginning of it and really laid the foundation for all the other trailers, I gotta give it a 5-star. Here comes Animal Abuse Sonic, of course. Sick and tired of you beating up mushroom people, Mario. Oh, this is something that people wanted for a long time because of the battles between Sega and Nintendo. But at this point, Sega was making so many Sonic games for Nintendo, it really wasn't that big of a surprise. But still, really cool. And now they do radical dances, and they go and, like, have competitions in the Olympics. Not regulated, though. Not a single soul at the Olympics committee knows that they're having these competitions. They're unregulated! Yeah, every time they try to catch them and stop them, it's just too dang fast. Now, for this trailer, I gotta admit, it's not as cool as Snake. Because really, there isn't any, like, Sonic fanfare as much as Snake. Because you have the bloop, you know, with Snake. You have the intro that's, you know, very reminiscent of Snake. Sonic, on the other hand, is just him running fast. Which I guess that, I mean, that is Sonic. He just runs fast. But you would have expected maybe, like, him running through, like, a Sonic stage. Like, maybe doing maybe a flip. Give the man a flip. Instead, it's kind of just Mario in one of the adventure stages, if I'm correct. And he just goes, bop! And then trailer starts. I mean, you got the Sonic music. Personally, I would have much more preferred Sonic R music. Super Sonic Racing! My nipples would have been full erect for that. But that didn't happen. We still got some kick butt music, you know? I always hate Sonic music, but I've never been a big fan of video game music having lyrics, but that's just me. I mean, if you like it, it's subjective, it's music, so whatever. But I just never really liked it, which is why I wasn't a big fan of the Smash Ultimate intro, but that's also because every time the lady goes for the high notes at the beginning, she puts literally zero effort into it. Search your soul and reawaken the undying I guess so. So I gotta say, other than the shock factor of Sonic finally being in the ring with Mario, which I'm not actually sure what came out first, Olympics or Smash, but putting that aside, it was a pretty underwhelming trailer, and I gotta say, I would give it 2 stars out of 5. Wasn't my favorite. I feel like it could have had more fanfare, but it's still cool to see Sonic in the Smash universe. And I feel like it's mostly surreal to people who were living the Nintendo versus Sega competition back in the day. Personally, I was born in the N64 era, so I didn't really get that. But I can understand why people would still have that, what's going on here? Also, at no point did they ever seem like they hate each other. Each one is just like, we're just hanging out because we love each other. I feel like there could have been more hate. More hate. 2 stars, 0 hate. Disgusting. I wanted Sonic to eat a corn dog on his corpse. Holy shit, Ryan, you went too far. Heartbeat of battle. No friendship, silly! Wee! And crippling debt. We'll pay off all your debts if you go into Smash Brothers. Bang! Done. That stupid Tanuki ain't getting my money. Except he's gonna get my Smash Bros. Money. Winners go the spoils, boys. Give me your money, bitch. You don't understand. You know how much crippling debt I have? Every time the sucker gets me with another. Hey, you wanna build up your house? Do I wanna build up my house? Do I wanna build up my house, Tanuki Man? I'm willing to kidnap Mario. You know how much that bitch Princess Peach will give me? Nothing, because she pays in shrooms. So the villagers is a cool one, because villagers is one that I never thought would be in Smash Brothers, just because how do you put a character that is in a zero violent game and it's just hanging out with villagers, getting money, building your town, a simulator game, essentially. How are they going to actually add him to the game? And then he grows trees and he chops them down on people, and then I got my answer, you know? I mean, I guess we've technically had characters that were in non-violent, like you got Dr. Mario, I guess. But most of the time, they're all from action games. But I was still really happy to see Villager in the game, just because Animal Crossing is such a big part of Nintendo. It's nice to see them, you know, put in a Smash. Because like I said, Smash Bros. Almost seems like a game that is like a love letter to all video games. Everybody gets in. But as far as the trailer goes, I think it's a pretty average one as well, just because it was kind of a connection to the entire intro. So I feel like it's in the same category as Sonic. What, it was more shiny, but it was also short. I think I'd give it a 2 as well. Though we did put Mario in a net. 2.5 for kidnapped Mario. 2.5. Top secret samurai incident happened. I don't got legs anymore. That's why I changed my clothes. Because I've been in the hospital for 7 weeks trying to put my legs back together. It didn't work. But I know what you're asking. Well, Ryan, what the heck are these? Crab appendages. These are crab appendages, folks. Not legs. Don't got those anymore. Just crab appendages. If we were in a dire scenario where it was life or death and, cannibalism's in the go, I just want you to know my legs are made of crab meat, so... Who's the dummy now? Sometimes I worry about myself, folks. Think to myself, Ryan, you know you just say it's one day later. And my brain went with a samurai attack, so... Take that how you will. Oh, God, of course, this one. I'm getting goddamn goosebumps just rewatching this. I remember this moment. Yeah! I gotta let it out. This is... Oh my god, I love Mega Man so much. And of course, this music is one of my favorite tracks of all time because I am a basic bitch when it comes to music. What's the other music I like, Ryan? Well, I like Megalovania. Get out. Look at what you did to Mega Man. He's dead because of you. Oh, so good. Oh my gosh, I'm not even kidding, guys. I actually am getting goosebumps from this. Also, who knew Mario drops coins like Sonic? I didn't know it, but now we do. You think Mega Man wasn't gonna get a good squeeze before he made his debut? I hate Yellow Devil with every fiber of my being as someone who beat Mega Man 1. But, that all aside, I absolutely love this trailer. If I remember correctly, he was the first big shock announcement for Smash Brothers Wii U. And my god, what a freaking one to get. Mega Man X may be associated with the PlayStation, but Mega Man Original, the first six, is synonymous with Nintendo. And it was a perfect fit for Smash Brothers. This is a 5-star one for sure for me. Oh my gosh, the remix of Mega Man and if I remember correctly, it's Mega Man 2 Wily's Stage 2, but it's one of the most popular Mega Man tracks. The way the freaking guitar is playing it, I want to go kick the shit out of some people right now. Right now. I don't care if I go to jail. The police officers will hear the music and they'll understand because they'll be beating up people too. More than likely me, though. I mean, that seems like the right thing to do. This one is what I consider a almost perfect character trailer. Because not only do you get the fanfare, the music, you also get the most important part, showing off the character. And also telling a story to show off the character. So the intro is amazing because you have that iconic shot of Mega Man up there. You have the music start playing, you're hype as shit, and then it shows off gameplay. And not just showing off gameplay, they do a little bit where he loses and shows off that he has all the character's powers from older games, which shows off what he can do in the game, which is absolutely perfect. So right now, if I remember correctly, I've got 2 5-stars, and that's Snake and Mega Man. Now, if I'm going to choose which one's better, I have to say Mega Man's was better because it's the perfect package. And the one that it seems like after this is kind of the standard when it comes to making trailers, if you think about the ones that are the new ones. The only thing that I feel Snake has over Mega Man is the shock value, because I feel like as much as Mega Man was a shocker, it felt like it was only a matter of time till Mega Man showed up because of the connections with Mega Man and Nintendo. Unlike Snake, which has very little besides the NES games and the GameCube games, but they were kind of side projects. They were always a Sony property.
Breathe slowly as you hold this pose.
Are you feeling that Smash energy that you got from the last one? I know I sure did. Kirby, God bless him for trying. God bless him. He's like, I don't have legs. I only have feet. Hey, guys. You're doing good. I will destroy you. Holy shit.
Great. Keep it up.
I gotta say, this is the weirdest one for me. This is the weird character. I mean, Smash has always been known for adding characters like, why? Why? Why Jigglypuff? Why Wii Fit Trainer? I feel like it's a part of the experience to have characters that are just bizarre, you know? Sonic, you already been in the game. What are you doing here? Sonic Heroes, though. That's a weird one. I guess I'll add a little bit of that in the Sonic reveal trailer. I wasn't going to do, like, the re-reveals, though. Wii Fit Trainer is a hard one. As a package, as a minor character or the weird character, they knew no one was gonna be shitting their britches over Wii Fit Trainer. Like, there's gonna be that one Wii Fit fan in the back just going hog wild.
Yeah! Praise the sun. By the way, I can't be the only one
that finds it weird that Praise the Sun is a pose that she does and shoots a sunbeam. I mean, I don't do yoga or anything, but I kind of thought that was a Dark Souls meme. Or maybe it means Dark Souls for Smash.
That's what they do. The Dark Souls guy is literally just a reskin of Wii Fit Trainer.
But meme characters are just a part of Smash. Everyone loves meme characters, so I can't really shit on her for being in the game. I really don't have any gripes about that. And as far as the trailer goes, I actually really like the fact that it's all the Mario characters playing Wii Fit and trying to get in shape for Smash. And Kirby just feeling like exiled, but he's like, I ain't gonna give up because I ain't got no dang legs. Doesn't mean I can't do the pose. This is why Kirby was the one to survive out of everybody at the Smash Ultimate thing, because he's willing to do what no one else will. I'm gonna rate it a 3 just for Kirby, not for Wii Fit Trainer, for Kirby for trying his heart out. I probably should have rated these beforehand and actually put thought into them, but I'm actually doing this on the seat of my pants, so get ready for this being a messy list. I have absolutely no idea which one this is. But gosh darn, do those stars get me hyped as hell. This is the most gorgeous thing I've seen in a long time. Is he going to... What? What is going on? What is going on? I'm confused. Hold on a second. This is still Smash Bros, right? I didn't accidentally get in the wrong one. Of course, this probably was at Nintendo Direct, and they were trying to trick people into thinking it was a Mario Kart character. But instead, it was... I have no idea. I actually have never seen his trailer, so I don't actually know what this is. Kirby, why you gotta always eat shit, bud? You have the flexibility from the last one, alright? What is that? Is it King Dedede? What the hell? This was Rosalina's trailer?
You fat brethren.
What the? What a strange way to reveal Rosalina. What? What the hell? I'm so confused, guys. I'm honest with you guys. I've never seen his trailer. I honest to God thought the video just messed up.
Wait. Hold on a second, guys. Guys, quick question. Quick and boring question. Why was in the scene to show of Rosalina her almost dying on a plane?
Remember that scene in Galaxy when she almost fell off a plane and died? I sure do. Oh, what? Didn't know you could do that. Be honest, I've never played Rosalina, so. It's a lot of things I don't know. Absolutely adorable. But who the hell won the race? You know, I got big props to the Luma. Big props to the Luma for being okay with Kirby riding his brother. You know, as a surprise trailer, I guess it's pretty cool. I don't know because I actually didn't see this when it came out. I don't remember it at all. I don't know where it was presented. I imagine this was a trick trailer, right? It was probably, Kirby in Mario Kart. That's probably what people thought. And to be honest, kind of surprised he's not, because they added Link at the time. Was Kirby in there? I don't remember. I don't remember all the characters, but I mean, it makes sense. But instead, it was Rosalina, which I don't know what I should do for a rating, because to be honest, I don't know if I liked it or not. Animation-wise, that was one of the most beautiful gosh darn trailers I've seen in a long time. The sparkle on this, we're talking about 7-year-old princess in a castle level of sparkle. I'm talking about this girl's riding her pony and just every time she sneezes, the world gets glittered. But as a trailer, seeing I didn't actually see it at the time, I imagine it was cool to see, even though it's Rosalina and I don't like it. Once again, a character that I don't know if anyone really had any hype for. I imagine there's some girls that really like Rosalina, but for me, Rosalina was just like, ah, oh, neat, that's cool, new character to add in there. But yeah, I'm having a hard time picking out this trailer because the trailer itself was like only 60% about Rosalina. The other was just like, wouldn't it be cool if you could play as Kirby in Mario Kart? So to be honest, I think this is probably my least favorite of all the trailers. I'm going to give it a 2. It was gorgeous, but the gameplay itself wasn't that impressive. There's a lot of just filler. Like, why'd you have her hanging off a plane? I mean, it showed off a little bit, but just because the trailer was more about the swerve than it was the character, which I guess does give you some points, but I feel like the swerve was, it was too swervy. Like, it didn't even feel, it felt like you're swerving the game type, which is, it's just weird. Not my favorite, but I could see people really enjoying it at the time as a neat little swerve. I gotta see something. It seems like Kirby wasn't in Mario Kart. I feel like I would have added points if this was a double trailer. Like, not only is it, hey, not only is Rosalina going to be in Smash, you're going to have Kirby in Mario Kart. You could have done a double whammy, which would have, I feel like, would have gotten some points. But instead, it just feels like a swerve for the sake of a swerve. And the Mario Kart fans don't really get anything out of it. So, to me, two out of five. My least favorite of the trailers. Oh, shit. Hot damn, look at that stylized art. And by that, I mean really, really heavy outlines. Doc, I'm disappointed that you didn't get in the game, you know, bud? Hot damn, this trailer's amazing. I feel like what this is. Oh, poor Sandbag. Oh my goodness. He didn't ask for this. You know who asked for it? A skinny Frenchman, that's who. Woo! That's what you get for little shaming, Samus. I always loved the little Mac character. He's one of the characters I always wanted to get good at, but I'm terrible at him. I love how you have the chocolate defender the whole time. Just shake it off, son. You know, I never understood that, you know? I never understood his power is steroids. So good. The answer is steroids. You know, Mac, I know you like working out on them heavy weight bars, but your big chocolate sidekick loves the chocolate bars. Oh, God, my mic died. Perfect timing. Camera to die. Perfect time, so you didn't have to see that debacle. God, I love that trailer. Like the last one, this is actually the first time I've ever seen the Little Mac one. I don't know why I just had a fallout with Smash through this period of the time. If I remember correctly, it was because I tried to avoid spoilers, so I could, for the first time, play Smash and unlock characters and be like, whoa! And in the end, I just found out about all the characters in one foul swoop. Like, I saw a picture of everybody and went, it is near impossible to play Smash Brothers and play the game without knowing the characters. Unless you just, you know, stop interneting and stuff. But I feel this one follows the formula to a T. You have an amazing trailer to get you hyped, and the workout, just like in the games, like just before he goes for the big fight, go to the next tournament where he trains. I would have liked to see him doing some biking, you know, like from the first one. But that's a nitpick. That really has nothing to do with the scoring. Just something I think would have been a cool throwback. I love hearing Doc throughout the whole entire trailer. I feel like that's a great little addition to the gameplay because it makes it feel like it's, you know, Punch-Out and him, you know, yelling to his corner. And fantastic. I loved all of it. This trailer really does show off a character. And one thing I actually like is having Samus do the height thing. Just being like, what? I get it's a joke, right? But I feel like people who haven't played Punch-Out would not know that Little Mac is actually little. Or that his name is even Little Mac. So I feel like it's good to show off that the size difference and, like, mention it. Because he was a small character. I don't know if when they made Punch-Out, they intentionally made him want to be small against the big guys. Or if that was just a graphic thing. I don't actually know when Little Mac became Little Mac. It may have been from the design from the beginning, but I'm not actually sure about that. Once again, another character that had to be in Smash Brothers. Little Mac is synonymous with NES history. It is an all-time classic. Little Mac deserves to be in this game. I was really happy to see him in there because I loved Punch-Out as a kid. It's a fantastic game. The trailer, there is only one gripe I have with the trailer. One gripe. And it's also in the game. Good God, do I hate his mega form. What is that? What the hell is that? Why is his signature move? He gets jacked up on the old roids, you know? I don't like the way it looks. It doesn't look cool. It makes him look like a caveman, and you're just like, why? It kind of goes against the whole theme of Little Mac or Punch-Out. Punch-Out's not like a magical game where all of a sudden, poof, I'm a magical man who's a giant Godzilla man. Is it from one of the games? Not that I know. I feel like his super punch that, you know, that the build-up bar, which is a cool little addition, I guess. I feel like he should have just had his super punch or his super uppercut be his signature move. Sure, it wouldn't have been as flashy, but I just think the giant thing looks just god-awful, and I hate it. So, just for that one reason, as much as it pains me because I love the trailer, but that reveal is a no-go. 4.5 for me. Almost a fiver, but just because I dislike the signature move and that reveal so much, I gotta give it to him. Though they did eat candy bars at the end, Ryan. No candy bars will save Mac's immense addiction to roids. Hey, thanks for watching, everybody. This was the first part of a multiple-part series I'm going to be doing, reacting to all of the character reveal trailers. At first, I was going to do this in one take, but then I realized, after seeing the 5 hours of footage I ended up recording, it's going to take a little while. So, I hope you enjoy this series, and there will be more to come. And whenever the second part comes out, I will make sure that it will be clickable right here, or it'll be in the description. Or somewheres. It'll probably be in a playlist somewheres. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy this little mini series I'm gonna be doing, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.